Dogecoin is going to make you rich. The evidence continuing to build and build and build new stats out that show overwhelmingly we are seeing a ton of millionaire millennials looking very heavily into the future here. A lot of excitement around that. Dogecoin making you rich is not as far away as a lot of people are starting to wonder. A lot of people are starting to believe. But that's not the only way you can make a heck of a lot of money. I thought this story was very dang interesting from the Boston Globe. A drawing that sold for $30 at a Concord estate sale, now worth $50 million. You can take a look. The drawing itself, I mean, not that impressive. But what makes this so valuable is not the drawing itself. It's the person who made it. Kind of like NFTs, it's more about the artist. It's more about the creator than it is about specifically the art, oftentimes. I mean, there are rare cases when that's not true. But in this case, this guy is a German painter, printmaker, and theorist of German Renaissance. Born in Nuremberg, he established his reputation and influence across all of Europe in his 20s, which is also really impressive, right? Around a really young age, and at that time it was actually a little bit on the older side because I didn't live as long, but still, that's impressive nonetheless. Born in 1471, kind of crazy that he still has art that's around today, but that's crazy. Whoever the person is that is making that much money from it, I mean, congratulations to you. But the real excitement here for the rest of us who are not going to get necessarily as lucky as that and find a $50 million work of art for $30 at an estate sale. I mean, come on, like, that's just absolutely ridiculous. I bet the person who made that sale feels very bad right now. In fact, they probably would like nothing more than to go back in time and not do that for $30. I feel like $50 million would have been a lot better. Hopefully the person who gets $50 million will give at least a couple mil to the person who did own it originally. I think that's the right thing to do. But here are some crazy stats that show overwhelmingly exactly what is coming. 83% of millennial millionaires own cryptocurrency. 83%. We're talking about everyone in the millennial millionaire group, pretty much. That's the overwhelming majority that are owning cryptocurrency and being excited about. When you look at millionaires, when you look at people who are on the younger side, the investments that they're making are going to be the long-term ones that are the most successful. You don't want to be too heavily investing in stocks or cryptocurrencies that have a very, very, very high tendency to be bought up by people who are on the older side, because they're not going to be able to hold it for as long. It doesn't have as much long-term use case and potential. So that's exciting to think about. And you compare that to 25% of Gen X that has crypto and 4% of baby boomers that have crypto. By the way, if you're wondering, and there's another very important thing about this, but if you're wondering, Gen Z is between 1996 and 2015. Millennials between 1977 and 1995. So a pretty large range there, close to 20 years. Then Gen X, 1965 to 1976, and baby boomers, 1946 to 1964. So there we go. Now you have an idea of where it is from and what's happening. But 25% of Gen X has cryptocurrency, and only 4% of baby boomers. But the more important thing here is not just what percentage of each group is holding cryptocurrency. The more important thing is that because it's so lopsided toward younger people, that shows us that as the next generation, which is Gen Z, between 1996 and 2015, starts to grow and grow and grow, that's going to be the next generation that has an even higher percentage owning cryptocurrency of the millionaires and of the people who are investing large amounts. That's huge. That's exciting because it shows us no matter what, we have huge waves of reinforcement coming for cryptocurrency. Huge, massive waves, because as these generations, like baby boomers and the greatest generation, start to go and not be with us here on the planet anymore, unfortunately, it's sad to see, but you know what? It's part of life. Then we will see new generations coming up and starting to have different patterns and different things. And even beyond that, more people that are going to have extremely high rates of adoption of cryptocurrency, extremely high literacy and understanding of the internet. So all of that's exciting to think about, and it just goes to show you exactly where we stand as a community. It goes to show you what's happening across the entire board. By the way, some more interesting stats here. I mean, I'm excited about that. And the other thing is, when it comes to Dogecoin, young people love Dogecoin at an even higher rate than cryptocurrency in general. We have already seen the stats. A huge percentage of people own Dogecoin who are investing and have more than $10,000 to invest. I mean, a massive percent. It's over 40% compared to Bitcoin, which is even higher percentage points, above 50, right? But still, Dogecoin's in the top three when it comes to being held. It's up there with Ethereum in terms of percentage of people that hold it with over $10,000 to invest. And that goes to show you how much room it has based on the number of holders versus the price and the market cap. A ton of room to grow does Dogecoin have. Some word trickery, wordplay there, indeed. But we are absolutely going to see some excitement there because younger people, especially in the Gen Z area, are going to be even more likely to like Dogecoin. And people younger and younger and younger, the more you like memes, the more you like fun, the more you like Elon Musk, the more likely you are to be on the younger side. And that just bodes well for the future of not just cryptocurrency as a whole, but Dogecoin especially being the most popular by far amongst young people. But 53%, by the way, of them have at least 50% of their wealth in crypto. That's millennial millionaires. Think about how crazy that is. 53%. 53% of millennial millionaires have more than 50% of their net worth right now into cryptocurrency. That's where the smart money is at. That's where the smart money of our group, of our people, of our age range, between these age ranges, and there are some people in our community who are on the older side, and that's awesome. I think you're definitely a step ahead of a lot of people who are in your same generation. But at the same time, I mean, that's crazy. To see that much of wealth being held in crypto just goes to show you how exciting we have, how much excitement we have for the future. And here's what's even more crazy. So we have 39% planning to add more to their crypto levels in 2022, which is a huge percent. That's 39% who want to do that. Then 48% of millionaires plan to add, or I'm sorry, I actually read that wrong. 48% is the number of millennial millionaires that plan to add to their cryptocurrency holdings in the next 12 months. Then 39% plan to maintain or hold their current crypto levels, and only 6% are actually planning to reduce their crypto investments. So we are seeing a ton of people, millennial millionaires, people with huge amounts of money to invest, starting to look at crypto and say, I want more of this in 2022. 48% is a huge number there, and I think that's exciting simply because it goes to show you that we're not even anywhere close to done, even for this run with cryptocurrency. And a lot of that money is going to be going into Dogecoin, especially as the catalysts start to hop into place. We're waiting, obviously, for the tax purposes, people trying to figure that out. One of the reasons why we can often see January, February, March being a big few months for cryptocurrency. We're also waiting on a couple of other question marks, like the government, things like that, wallets and Dogecoin's case. So we do have a number of things that we're still hoping for soon. But here's another cool stat. 30% have at least 75% of their wealth in Bitcoin. I mean, that's even more crazy. 75% of your wealth specifically in BTC, not even in other cryptos. That is going to change as people start to expand and invest in more cryptos across the board. But I mean, it's hard to look at all the stats and be anywhere besides at an extremely optimistic position of cryptocurrency and of Dogecoin, especially once you start to realize really what this means. Young people love Dogecoin. We do. I mean, it's just the truth. Doge is the best. How can you not like it? And I mean, shout out, by the way, to CNBC for helping to get some of that data. They're often good with that. An employee, by the way, did embezzle $154 million from Solana. You'd think maybe you do a couple million if you're a criminal, you're still going to get caught. I mean, it's not worth it anyway. But I mean, does anyone really who's a criminal think they're going to get away with taking this much? I mean, you probably won't even get away if you take a few hundred bucks from Sony. So, I mean, this is not smart. But they took $154 million and they thought they were smart. This person thought they were clever. They put it all into BTC. There we go. Now you can't touch it. I took it. What are you going to do about it? Well, it's actually pretty simple. All the government had to do is get the seed phrase, and then they were able to access the cryptocurrency. It turns out, if you're a criminal, you can't be doing stuff like that without expecting repercussions. Now, the money is getting returned. It's actually worth more than what it was when it was seized. But the other thing here is you want to make sure, for your own personal safety and stuff like that, make sure you have your seed phrases. Probably not wherever you live, don't keep your seed phrases there. Keep your seed phrases far away in a super secret safe place. Like, for example, a bank, you can put it maybe in a safety deposit box if you want. Now, you probably shouldn't even tell anyone the general place you're putting it. And also, one thing to do as well is keep some of your money, a lot of it at least, in different places. You can also have your seed phrases in multiple different accounts, in multiple different locations, multiple different ways to protect that. So make sure you're doing the safe stuff there. You do not want anyone to have your seed phrases because it does give them access to your account. Unfortunately, if you get it lost, right? But Elon Musk and Jack Dorsey as well, appear to mock Web3 in the latest buzzword in tech. This was a pretty funny exchange. We saw Elon Musk and Jack Dorsey going and making a little bit of fun of Web3. Now, Web1, okay, that's pretty good. Web2, all right, not too bad, not too shabby. Now, Web3 is basically the idea that the people are going to have control over cryptocurrency and over the internet more broadly. And it's kind of a little bit strange to see Jack Dorsey being a huge proponent of this, but I like that. I think he's right. We do need to see absolutely people taking control of social media, people taking control of the internet once more, which has not been the case, unfortunately, for a period of time here. But basically, Elon Musk said, "Where's Web3? I can't find it," jokingly. And I mean, he's right. Like, we haven't seen the decentralized internet that we want to see yet. We have not. Elon Musk hopefully will help with that, but I mean, you have to really go from the beginning. You have to make an actual phone that can then handle this and be willing to do it, because otherwise you're not going to be able to have apps, because then the apps are controlled by the app store. So you have to have a decentralized phone that's based off of crypto that then has decentralized blockchain technology with inside it that can never be taken control of by anyone else besides you. Now, there are some phones that will get you closer to that than others. Apple's a little bit more on the less close to that side, unfortunately. So hopefully Tesla will make a phone soon. And then I would definitely love to switch to a Tesla phone if possible and be able to access a lot of the things that you maybe can't access because the App Store decides that they don't want you to access it. They want to block it. Well, maybe I want to be able to access it and you don't want me to. That's not okay. So we need Web3 to help and make it more decentralized. Then Jack Dorsey responds, "It's somewhere between A and Z," basically making fun of A16Z, which is a venture capital firm that has invested heavily in blockchain and cryptocurrencies. And Jack Dorsey's even gone harder against VCs, basically saying that VCs are taking away some of the help that cryptocurrency brings to the world and taking away some of the shine and some of the people's power by simply going into crypto, changing things, taking control, taking positions, having influence, and then the people are left with less of that. And Jack has been calling that out. One of the things I like about Jack is that he's been calling this out lately. And there's a number of things I don't like that he's done in the past, and we do, of course, talk about that. A lot of things that I wish he had done differently, and I hope he does do differently. I really think he should be one of the biggest proponents of letting people say whatever the heck they want. And the more he goes toward that, the more I'm going to like what he's saying. And this is a step in the right direction, absolutely. There's no question about that. Elon Musk, Jack Dorsey, this conversation, you love to see it. And Elon Musk has the influence and ability. If he wants to, he can do it. I mean, he can make some of this stuff happen that he's hoping for and talking about here. I mean, it's hard, right? But it's not like impossible. He's Elon Musk. He has the power to take a little tiny company and turn it into a massive one. He's done that with multiple of them. With Tesla, it was already a little bit bigger when he kind of got his hands on it, but still, he took it from basically nothing in the terms of a massive company scale and then brought it to being one of the top 10 companies in the entire world with a huge, huge market cap as a stock, as a company, and he's just getting started with some of that stuff. We really do, Elon, we really need a Tesla phone. Come on. It's about dang time. It has to run on Dogecoin and other cryptocurrencies, and then we'll be good to go. Once we get our Tesla phone and we can hook it up to Starlink, then we won't have to worry anymore about the internet not being free. In fact, we'll be able to post whatever we want, whenever we want, and no one will be able to tell us no. No one will be able to say you can't do that. And that's really the most exciting thing, I think, about Web3 and about this next evolution in the internet. There's this tweet, by the way. I haven't seen Web3. Can anyone find it? And he also said M something something in response to Jack Dorsey. So, I mean, some funny stuff going on there. A lot of celebrities getting involved with that. And I was tweeting a little bit in the mix. So we have a lot of people in there having fun with it. But there we go. There's Elon. He liked a tweet of him talking. He's been liking some interviews from himself lately on Twitter and talking about other things on there. SpaceX flex is warranted. And also liking a lot of tweets about the Tesla. This is also pretty dang cool. Someone hooked up a Starlink terminal to a Tesla and was driving down the freeway 100 miles per hour and still was able to get a really high speed. Look at that. They were able to get that much speed. That's enough to stream on. And they did that driving down the road in a Tesla. I mean, the potential of this is just truly insane. The idea of getting internet anywhere you want, you can then go take a camper and still do live streams on YouTube, which is something I am going to be a very big fan of, obviously. And all of us will, because our favorite creators can now go wherever they want and stream. And you can do the same thing. If you live in a place that's rural oftentimes and doesn't have high quality internet, well, boom. Now that changes. This is why I'm excited about this. By the way, if you want to subscribe with notifications on, I'll let you know the second that Starlink stock IPOs, worth around $100 billion right now, could be worth way more pretty soon here. Now, technically, it's a big part of SpaceX, but it's also its own thing. And Elon Musk is saying he's going to make it its own stock, which means that you can own some of it. And I strongly encourage everyone to look at owning this. I mean, why the heck wouldn't you when stuff like that can happen? Airplanes are going to want it. Everyone's going to want it. He's innovating and changing the world one step at a time, which is just exciting stuff. But anyway, if you would like to go down there and smash the glorious like button, subscribe with notifications on, you can take a second to do that, or a minute, or 10 minutes. If you want to take an hour to press like button, however long you want to take, you're welcome to do that at this current point in time and have fun with it. But anyway, I'm Matt Wallace. This is Final Stand, and I will see you very shortly in the metaverse and in the next video, and also potentially somewhere else. Who knows?